Welcome to all the students of SMI BCom. I, Pooja Singh, will be teaching you the subject Business Communication 2 for the semester 4. We have completed the first chapter that was based on report writing and internal correspondence. Today we will start the unit 2 that is based on recent trends in business communication. In this, we will see the first topic that is internet. In this, we will see the email and websites. So let us first start with the internet. See, the technological advancements introduced in the field of communication have brought very much changes in the way business communication is being carried out today. With this, the barriers of space and time have totally been eliminated. The world has come closer and it is now possible to communicate with anyone situated at any corner of the world with speed and ease. And this has happened only because of the internet. So, according to the Oxford Dictionary definition, internet is an arrangement of connected computers which lets the computer users all over the globe exchange data. So, because of internet, one can connect everyone and can exchange data, information, videos, anything else. With the help of internet, one can do online shopping, one can search information, one can have access to all kinds of information, videos, PPT presentation, anything, and this all is possible with the help of internet. So it has become the most effective business tool in the contemporary world and can be described as a global meeting place where people from every corner of the world can come simultaneously. So it is the most the internet is the most effective business tool in this contemporary world. And it has made the world a very smaller place where anyone from every corner of the world can connect everyone simultaneously. So this is what internet is. Now let us see the advantages of internet. The first one is availability of knowledge. See, the internet has become an ocean of knowledge and is ever growing. It has definitions, descriptions, and history of everything. And it has the information of almost all important personalities and answers to any and every question that one can think of. So one can say that there is a huge amount of information available on the internet for just about every subject known to man, ranging from the government law and services, trade fairs and conferences, market information, new ideas and technical support. Every knowledge is available on the internet. So all this available is not just in a text form, but also in the form of PPT presentations, videos as well. So a variety of information sources can be accessed just sitting in front of a computer and having a net connectivity. So this is the first advantage of internet, that is availability of knowledge. The next comes convenience. See, the net permits us to do a lot of work sitting in one place. One does not have to visit another place to get access for any information. Just sitting at one place, you can get access to all the informations and variety of things from your home only. So this is what convenience here means. Next comes your environment friendly. How it is environment friendly? See, as more and more newspapers, magazines and books are available on electronic format, that we call as e-books or e-magazines, obtaining them is easy. So as all transactions are now all the transactions are also in virtual format apart from the publications themselves, so it is environment friendly as paper requires soft wood and printing can add to pollution. So almost all companies have opted for green option. So according to which all their communication including their annual reports are on email. So there is no paperwork. So in this way it is a environment friendly. Next is communication. See, one of the most important aspects of the internet is that it makes communication fast, quick, safe, convenient, and very economical. So email is now an essential communication tool in business, and it is also excellent for keeping in touch with family and friends. Okay, so you can do a chat or a video chat facilities from anywhere in the world to anywhere in the world to any person. So just you need a net support. Now next comes makes the world smaller. See, as data transfer and communication through the net becomes more and more convenient, instantaneous and economical, distances do not matter anymore. Not just files, folders, multimedia messages, and even money can be transferred over long distances. So individuals migrate to other regions and countries for better opportunities. Organizations have developed global footprints. Coordination of work from all the offshore facilities has become extremely comfortable. In this way, the world has become very smaller. Next comes social network. See, networking on the net to form virtual relationships and communities helps people stay connected. They can greet, chat, video chat, pass comments, share information and pictures, give opinions, etc. with the help of the internet. Next is entertainment. See, this is one area where the internet is used heavily. This includes movies, songs, games, etc. So one can download innumerable games, music, videos, movies, and a host of other entertainment software from the internet, and most of which are free. So people can even play with virtual opponents living in some other part of the world. Okay. Now next comes data storage facility. See, the internet creates virtual storage for a lot of data, including text, music, pictures, videos, etc. And people can store a lot of their valuable memories in this manner. So the advantage is that unlike hard copies or film copies, they do not require physical storage space and are not subject to wear and tear. So they can also be stored separately and safely on external hard drives. So even in businesses, government offices, educational institutions, film data digitization is being taken up in a massive scale to take the advantage of this. So it is very easy to retrieve the data stored in this manner. So in this, we can store our data. We doesn't need to keep a hard copy of it, okay? Now next comes renders services. See, many services are now provided on the internet, such as online banking, job seeking, online shopping and applications, and hotel reservations, ticket booking. So all these services are now available online, and some of these services are also available offline or whichever is convenient to the customer. So these were the advantages of internet, that is availability of knowledge, convenience, environment friendly, communication, makes the world smaller, social network, entertainment, data storage facility, and renders services. Now we will see the disadvantages. In this, first comes reduces face-to-face communication. Why it is said it reduces a face-to-face communication? Because people are deprived of face-to-face contact with their acquaintances and business partners, because such dependence on the internet denies them the opportunity to meet and interact with people of varied interest and develop their personalities as individuals. We can't see how a person particularly looks like or how the person personally behaves. So it reduces the face-to-face communication with this digital, with this internet facility. Next comes availability of knowledge. People can ask for information whenever they are in doubt. However, the answers may be given by unqualified persons with limited knowledge about the subject. So this may be misleading and even confusing if contradictory data are given. If wrong data is provided over the internet, then we can avail the wrong knowledge from that. So availability of knowledge is good, but sometimes it may be misleading. Next comes social network. People tend to spend a lot of time which they could use for more productive purposes. And secondly, it can lead to a lot of false relationship, leading to depression and even suicidal tendencies. So especially when children get into these networks, they can be exposed to unwanted and unhealthy sites, leading them to astray. So social network is good to connect with the people who we know, but sometimes it can be very dangerous and lead to depression and suicides. Okay. Now next comes less physical activity. As people spend a lot of time sitting in front of the computers or their desktop, they are not physically active. Unless they make conscious effort to exercise and maintain, they can develop lifestyle issues like obesity, diabetes, etc. Next one is data storage. Secrecy and safety from hackers are the main issues facing these organizations. So data storage, we are able to store the data online, but most important aspect of this is the safety from the hackers, because there are many more chances that these data can be retrieved by the hackers and can be used for the wrong purposes. Next is addiction to entertainment. Children and adults who get used to this will spend a lot of time sitting in one place indoors, and they do not get an opportunity to interact with their peers. So this can distort their personalities. Secondly, internet has made piracy of movies and songs easy, so which has indirectly impacted the entertainment industry. Next is security issues. See, there are many issues with the security of data. Virus, malware, spyware, etc. can enter the computers through the net and create problems for the users. So these were the disadvantages of the internet. Now we will see email. See, email is an electronic mail, and it is extremely fast and can be sent to anyone irrespective of their physical location. We can send electronic files through email in the form of words, tables, pictures, sounds, videos, graphs, and so on. Also, the cost involved in sending and receiving emails is not much. So this is what email is. It is an electronic mail, and this is widely used in businesses to send reports, communication of meetings, etc. Is sent through the emails. And the email provides a lot of facilities, like sending the electronic form of words, tables, pictures, sounds, videos, graphs, and so on. Okay, so we will begin with the advantages of email. The first advantage is speed. See, email reaches the receiver within few minutes or even seconds of being sent, whereas the sending the message in hard copy takes much longer time. Hence, the extent of sending message or documents through ordinary post is becoming insignificant, and the use of email is getting increased day by day. Next one is multiple receiver. Emails can be sent at the same time to a large number of receivers with ease. If you want to send the same email to a lot of people, then this facility is available in email. But if you want to send the hard copy of the same thing to the multiple receivers, then you have to send multiple copies of it, and it takes a lot of time also. So in this case, email is very handy. Next comes convenience. See, communicating through a phone call can cause inconvenience to the receiver if he is busy with other work, whereas an email reaches the receiver without disturbing him, and he can read the messages at ease whenever possible. Whenever he gets the time, he can read the email. So this is what the convenience here means. Next one is time zone difference. Time zone differences make it difficult to communicate with someone from the other part of the world on phone. This is not the case with email. It can be sent at any time convenient to the sender, and the receiver can check it at the start of the next working day. So time zone differences eliminated in the case of email. Next one is receiver's availability. So what does this means? That unlike phone call, an email does not depend on the availability of the recipient at that particular moment. Receiver gets it as soon as he checks his mail box, and communication continues provided he checks it regularly. See, in the phone call, a person should be there so that we can talk to that person. But in case of email, that is not the case. Whenever the receiver gets the time, he can just check out the mail and can just reply to it. Okay, so this is what the receiver's availability here means. Next one is confidential and safe. It is relatively easier to tamper with the hard copy messages sent through the conventional methods, whereas email accounts are password protected and only authorized persons can access them. So messages sent through email remain confidential and secured. Next one is instant clarification. If the sender and the receiver both are online at the same time, so they can exchange further clarification and additional information right away and at that moment only. Next one is cost effective. Email is very cost effective and cheaper than postal mail, All the cost of sending a message is same, whether it is being sent within the same building or across the world. It means what? Whether you want to send the message to the other person who is sitting in the another country, or to a person who is just a few meters away from you, or a few kilometers away from you, the cost is the same only. It doesn't change with the distance. But this is not same in case of postal mail. So this is what cost effective here means. Next comes multimedia exchanges possible. It is possible to exchange information in the form of multimedia messages through emails such as sounds, images, videos, applications, etc. Next one is storage and access. Email messages can be easily saved on a computer and quickly referred to whenever required. So storage and access facilities also there in the email. Next is helps in marketing. See, using email distribution lists, the marketing department can send information such as sales leads, pamphlets, price charges, product announcements, etc. to the and the competitive information simultaneously to salespeople anywhere in any part of the world. So in this way, it helps in marketing of the product also. So these were the advantages of email. Now we will see the limitations of email. In this, first comes threat of virus. See, it is possible to send virus through emails and corrupt the receiver's computer. So this is the very, very important limitation of email, that is threat of virus. Because most of the virus travel to the computer, host computer, through emails only. So the first one is threat of virus. Next is availability of internet. Sending and receiving emails is only possible when both the sender and the receiver have access to internet, which is not widespread in India as compared to the developed country. So this is the another limitation of email which creates problem in using this facility. Next is difficulty in sending heavy files. See, it becomes very difficult to send heavy files or too many files through email, as they need to be sent separately or through a more different mode, which is very time consuming sometimes. And the last one is physical documents. It is not possible to send physical documents through email which are required in hard copy, such as legal or ownership documents. So there are various documents which are required to be in physical form rather than in electronic form. So that is also not possible in the case of email. So these are the four limitations of the email, that is threat of virus, availability of internet, difficulty in sending heavy files, and physical documents. Now we move on to the next, that is websites. See, a website also is a collection of web pages and related content that is identified by a common domain name and published on at least one web server. All publicly accessible websites collectively constitute the World Wide Web, that is WW. You have seen that whenever we tag a website, first we have to write WW, that is World Wide Web. See, there are also private websites that can only be accessed on a private network, such as company's internal website for its employees. So that particular website is only available for the members of the company. Okay, each website has a unique internet address known as Uniform Resource Locator, that is URL. It is accessible through the internet or a private local area network. So this is what a website is. We have the various websites, and from those websites we come to know about the information of that particular company or about that particular thing. So this is what a website is. Okay, and these all publicly accessible websites collectively constitute the World Wide Web, that is www. Now let us move on to the advantages of the websites. First is wider reach. Websites can have a vast reach across the globe, as millions of internet users can search and visit those websites without any hindrance. Next one is anytime access. Anyone can access information on website on any day at any time of the day, even beyond the organization's working hours. Next is contact information. It is easier to find out all the contact details of the organization on its website. Example, phone numbers, postal addresses, and email addresses. For example, if you want to have the phone number of a college, then you can visit to the college website and you can get the important emails and phone at the college. So this is how websites helps in contact information. Next one is logical presentation. Websites provide information in a very logical and easy to understand manner. Visitors can search sites and navigate through its pages easily and avail offline facilities. For example, in case of Savitribai Phule Pune University, you can just go to that website and you can check whatever the information you need, whether you want to know about the exams, filling of exam forms or your results or anything. You can just, you have to go to that particular website, you have to search, and you can get all the information in a very logical order. So this is what logical presentation here means. Next is security. Website provides facility of entering confidential information such as passwords and debit or credit card numbers in an encrypted form. This ensures security in financial and selling transactions. Next one is social media platform. See, there are various social media websites which are rapidly becoming popular, such as Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn. So these are the social media websites which are becoming popular among the youngsters as well as among the adults also. So the business organization can use these kinds of platforms to create awareness for them or for their product. Next one is instant support. Many websites provide 24/7 online support to their users and customers. And the last one is business information. See, it is an effective way of communicating important business information to general public or specific target readers with the help of the websites. So these were the advantages of websites. First one is wider reach, anytime access, contact information, logical presentation, security, social media platform, instant support, and business information. Now we will see the limitations of websites in this. The first one is adverse publicity. Many websites provide facility of posting online feedback about the company's product and the services offered by them. So unsatisfied customers can spread bad words about the company, which can affect the goodwill of the company or can affect the buying decisions of the other potential buyers and may hamper the company's image permanently. So in this way, it can be an adverse publicity. Next one is reliability of information. The information on website may become outdated and not reliable, and sometimes there is no way for visitors to check the authenticity of information because there are many fake websites available on internet. So reliability of information is the key aspect whether the information provided on such websites are true or not. Next one is spam emails. Organizations provide email addresses or contact us forms on their websites often end up getting their mailbox filled with spam emails. So this is the one more limitations of the website. Sometimes you visit some other website and they want our email, and just we put our email on that particular website and they use that information by sending us the so many emails, and due to this our mailbox get filled. So this is what spam emails means. Okay. Next comes difficulty in reaching target audience. Due to the nature of internet, presence of millions of its users and millions of websites, it becomes difficult for the organization to find and reach the right audience. So these were the four limitations: adverse publicity, reliability of information, spam emails, and last, difficulty in reaching target audience. So though there are certain limitations of websites, it is essential for the organization to have their own websites. In today's competitive world, websites are becoming indispensable as they provide the potential for creating awareness, business exposure, favorable image, advertising, and in turn increased sales. So if you see, every organization, or whether it is a educational institution also, or any entertainment websites also, so there is a website of the particular thing where you can just go and search for the information of whatever you want to need. So because of this limitations also, there is a need for the websites in today's world. So these were the limitations of website. So we have completed the internet in which email and see the another part of this chapter. Till then, thank you.